Why would you get a mortar? I mean, yeah, you can pin riflemen with your MG42s and shoot them with your mortar, but still a mortar? I don't know. And of course he's tier 2, which means unless the American player gets either more snipers or something, we're gonna see an M8 sometime soon. And here we go, the M8 is just being built, just at the 15 minute 04, 05, 06 second mark. And the Wehrmacht player doesn't have a counter for the M8 at the moment, except for some mines that are scattered around the map. Once again, the American player keeps up the harassment in the south and manages to do a good job, while at the same time the Wehrmacht player has moved the mine super equipped pioneer squad just outside the American base and tries to cut him off as well. Reifman once again retreating the face of the MG42 in that big house in the north, in the northeast. An MG42 has been there for quite a while another American squad goes down, and that is probably the engineers by the North Victory Point. I would say, squad preservation wise, the Wehrmacht player seems to be showing a higher skill than the American player, although I wouldn't say that for his snipers, but everything else is just in shape. I mean, the amount of engineers and riflemen that has been lost by the American player is quite high. However, that sniper, he seems to be paying for himself. He just killed another pioneer squad and he managed to take two snipers out and the previous minutes of the game, and of course it's he's always a threat to that MGs. And of course the mortar that made their way to the field and just set camp behind that MG42 by that house in the northeast. I don't know what's wrong with that house. I would like to have seen that MG42 be a little more active. I'm a bit concerned about the choice of the mortar, but whatever, I'm not the one playing, right? And things seem to be going kind of decent for the Wehrmacht player, so I wouldn't say anything. Reifman hit a mine, while in some previous seconds, the M8 took a shot from the back, just outside of the Wehrmacht base, and now has moved to the north. And good luck to the bug catching up with the M8. While a pioneer goes down by the northmost strategic point, they went down to the sniper and the nearby rifleman squad. Pack almost catches up with the M8, but that building is gonna be a pain in the ass for the pack's line of sight. You will have to maneuver in such a position that will actually expose him, the pack, to either the sniper or of course the rifleman squad. And the mate is kind of content with staying just behind that house, practically denying the house to the Wehrmacht MG42. Wehrmacht sniper opening fire on that rifleman squad, and American sniper opening fire on the MG42. That's a really, really risky move by both snipers. Recon run is on the way. Wehrmacht player realizes and retreats with his sniper in time. In the south, Flamer pioneer squad is in danger of going down to those riflemen unless they retreat soon. Something that they do not seem to be doing, and yes, they are going down. So losses seem to be mounting up for the Wehrmacht player as well. He seems to be in a kind of a tough spot right now. He seems to actually micring the packs, trying to hunt down the M8, keeping up with the sniper, and of course it's positioning to the northeast. They meet the bike, a sniper, are down four members, do have to retreat. However, something went down, and that must have been a pack. A Wehrmacht pack has gone down by the
enemy unit down.
northern strategic point, while the American player has two snipers on the field, and that is actually terrifying for those MG42s that are going to go down so quickly you won't even notice. Wow. Let's see if that MG42 is lucky and made its way back to the base. Yes, it is. One sniper out by the Wehrmacht player, two by the American player. M8 in top shape once again, has been repaired by the American base. American sniper at the veterans level 1, close to getting veterans level 2, and the other sniper, of course, no veterans yet. I think that Wehrmacht sniper is gonna have a rough day, especially if a recon run is on top of him. Pioneer going down by the north is the strategic point. Really, really, those losses by the Wehrmacht player in those last minutes of the game seem to be quite to be having a really, really bad effect on his ability to control the map, a map that now is in the hands of the American player. Actually, yeah, most of the map is in the hands of the American player. The Wehrmacht player just have two resource points. It's very few map to have. And actually, Rifleman retreat in the south, and we have a Puma. So yeah, maybe the Wehrmacht player has not been replenishing his losses due to the fact that he wanted to tech up. However, now he just lost his mortar as well. His sniper is lurking around, trying to get a counter snipe. Let's see if this will happen. Nope, it won't happen. Wehrmacht sniper too slow, and the American is gonna be fine. An M1 anti-tank gun out by the American player. That's gonna spell the end of the Puma. Should the Puma get close to that AT gun? And now the American player is in a commanding position. As I said just before, the map is in his hands. The victory points are in his hands. Well, at least three of them and one, I guess, going to his hands shortly after. And the Wehrmacht player is in a kind of a pickle. What is he gonna do with his Pumas? Well, unless he upguns them, he's not gonna be able to fight off that M8. And that MG42 that was in the sub just went down. Go figure. Now the Wehrmacht player has one MG42, one pack, two Pumas, a sniper, and a mortar. And that, and the Volksgrenadier squad out of nowhere, and the Nibelwerfer right now. Nibelwerfer is, of course, to counter the AT gun, and probably to stop some copping, I guess. But still, those snipers are gonna make quick work of any unit that's trying to cap back victory points or strategic points. The riflemen, of course, are gonna lurk nearby right now. They're gonna be healed back at the base and stay around the map, holding down the victory points. And that is, of course, a tough position for the Wehrmacht player to break, because if you have already set up your defenses with your MGs, you're fine. But if you don't have any infantry, in order to fight back the riflemen, and your only standing chance of driving them off what area they actually guard is those Pumas, then you're in a kind of a deep water. The American player just airdropped an AT gun by the south west strategic point, and he's gonna lock down that sector as well against those Pumas. Middle is locked down by the other AT gun, and the north is locked down by the M8. So there you go. The American player seems to have it all covered by now. Snipers opening fire on some Volksgrenadier squads. Recon run going. Being used. I don't know exactly for what reason. Actually, did the Wehrmacht sniper go down? I think I missed that. While a strafing run takes down Pioneer squad and causes some losses to those two MG42s. In the south, Nibelwerfer opening fire in the middle manages to bring down the health and kill a squad member by that AT gun. And now the Pumas move in and manage to kill the AT gun. So yeah, there you go, that was a good move, but what are you gonna do for the M8 that's following up? Do you have anything to do? The Pumas smartly target the AT gun, however that M8 is gonna probably kill that Puma. End time now. Nope, not yet. And the Wehrmacht pack is kind of oddly positioned by the outskirts of the Wehrmacht base, doing absolutely nothing at the moment, giving the M8 complete control of the field. And that Puma just went down. The American AT gun is still alive. Actually, take that back, it just went down to the fire of the Nibelwerfer. M8 may be in danger of going down as well. No, not really, but the bridge did went down too, so that's weird. The west bridge leading to the middle just collapsed under the fire of the Nibelwerfer, while we are at the 26 minute 31, 32, 33, 34, 35 second mark. Okay, the Wehrmacht player is still trying to fight back, but I kind of feel this is a pointless fight. Snipers and rifle squad in the south grab up false grenadiers, and that MG42, I don't know what they are doing there. There are two snipers nearby. Move away. What are you doing? Move away. Move away. Nope, you don't move away, you die. Murder fire, of course, in the area and the Puma nearby. Is it gonna be enough to kill the snipers or the rifle squad? Doesn't seem to be the case. And the Puma just got a damaged engine out of his own mortar team? That is awesome. Well, at least the AD gun of the American player just went down to the Puma. However, three Rathman squads, probably with stickies, are making their way there. They're gonna recrew that AD gun. And what are you gonna do about that, Mr. Wehrmacht player? Okay, you're gonna get more Pumas, but that is not the point. Your Pumas are fine, okay? They can possibly drive off the riflemen. Problem is, what do you do after that? You move in and you come with your one false grenadier squad? That's just one combat infantry unit on the field right now, and that is kind of terrible, I would say. Well, at least the combined effort of the Nibelwerfer, the Volks, and the MG42 in the south manages to drive off those riflemen, and the AT gun is in danger of going down, but will those false grenadiers make it in time? Let's find out. Snipers closing on the position. Open fire on the Volks. Two Volks down. And the AT gun is still alive for some reason. Now the American snipers are at Veterans level 2 and Veterans level 1 respectively. While at the same time, the M8 has made its way into the Wehrmacht blaze. The blaze? Well, I meant base, but you get the point. It took down the pack that was stationed right at the entrance of the base, as well as the Nibelwerfer. But just went down to MG fire? Could be. While, of course, at the same time, some pioneers or some folks actually. It's an MG team that went down in the south, while the paratrooped AT gun by the American player gets decimated by the nearby Pumas that was really funny to see. And so does the rifle.